Hi, welcome to Born for Homeschool. I'm Rachel Bourne. Here at Born for Homeschool, we share tips and tricks, information, and encouragement to simply support you in your homeschool. Today, we're going to talk about a homeschool portfolio and the five simple steps I take to create our portfolios for the year. So let's talk about what is a homeschool portfolio. A homeschool portfolio is a tool to demonstrate academic progress. It's basically a summary of your homeschool year. So what should be included in a homeschool portfolio? Well, at the very least, you should include everything that's required by law. And I'll talk about that in just a few minutes. A few other things that you may want to include in your portfolio would be a copy of all legal documents, standardized test scores, attendance chart or hours of instruction, a curriculum log, reading list, field trip log, a log of educational movies, shows, or documentaries your student watched, awards or certificates your student has earned, student work samples, and you may want to include a brief summary of the learning that took place in your homeschool. So here are five simple steps on how to create a homeschool portfolio. Number one, research your requirements. I have found an excellent resource in researching the requirements for our state to be hslda.org. I will link their website in the description box below. At hslda.org, you can find the specific portfolio requirements for the state that you live in. Step number two, gather your supplies. For each traditional homeschool portfolio, you will need a binder, page dividers, page protectors for paper, or you can just use a three-hole punch to insert the pages directly. You may also want page protectors for photos. You may want your computer, or you'll need a paper and pen. And you may also find it helpful to have Notepad or Post-it note nearby to make notes of things that you may want to include along the way. Once you have the supplies you need, you're ready to move on to step three, which is compile the contents. So it seems to make sense for our homeschooling style for me to divide our homeschool portfolios by subject. However, you may find it works better for your family to divide your portfolio by date or by unit study, and that's fine, whatever makes sense to you. So I grab a divider and choose the first subject that I'm going to include in our portfolio, and then I will use the reading log that I have created and maintained throughout the year, and I will list out all of the curriculum and books that we used for that subject. I then write a few summary sentences of how we studied the subject and what learning took place, and then I finish off that section including work samples from the student. And then I just move on to the next subject and we do the same thing. I list the subject and the reading materials we use. I do a quick summary of the subject and then finish off with work samples from the student. So this is where I usually pull out my homeschool planner and I flip through the pages to make sure that I'm not missing any key things we did throughout the year that I wanted to include in our portfolios. I also will take the opportunity to jot down some notes on photos that I may want to include in our portfolio and make sure that I send those to the printers to get printed. So that brings us to step number four, which is add the finishing touches. I like to create a fun cover for our portfolios each year, and then I make sure to insert the photos I want to include in our portfolios. Step number five, enjoy your work. Creating a homeschool portfolio is simple, but it does take work. I hope that once you're finished with your portfolio, you have a treasure that you can flip through again and again to remind you of the time, the growing, the learning that took place over your last homeschool year. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you have, please leave it a thumbs up. Here at Born for Homeschool, you'll find weekly videos of tips and tricks, information and encouragement to support you in your homeschool.